Heyo, my planet coaster friends, Johnny5 Alive here, and welcome back to another episode of Coaster Spotlight. And in today's video, we're going to be looking at Eldfjall, created by Afgyhi. So stay tuned and let's check it out. Alright, this was sent in by one of our Discord builders and silver patrons, Afgyhi. Thank you so much for your support. And here he says, "This is my first attempt on a 4K coaster blueprint. It took quite a long time to build, but it was a great fun and I learned a lot. I wanted to do a volcano since the adventure DLC came out with all the lava stuff. I hope you like it and that it is good enough for a spotlight. I really love the videos that you make, so please continue making them." Alright, very quick introduction. Pretty exciting stuff here, guys. Let's jump right on into this. Look at this volcano. Tons of triggered events, lava, lighting. It looks very spectacular. The sign... Whoa! And here comes the lava. Oh, this is really cool. I mean, the spotlight takes place on the outside before we even get started. A lot of the stuff we're not going to see from the rider's perspective, so we might as well check it out right now. I was just going to say that this sign, it changes colors. It's quite a clever sign. What is it made out of here? All right. They change colors. The sign turns off when the volcano fizzles out. Lots of eruptions. Looks very cool. Let's speed it up a little bit so you guys could get an idea of the time lapse. And there's a lot of stuff going on the inside that I have not seen. I'm pretty excited about it. Let's watch this one more time. Very cool. I love the gurgling lava rippling down. That's spectacular. Very good job on all those triggered events. The volcano looks great. What do you guys say we give this coaster a ride? Look at that track. Oh my. So it looks like we have the new swinging mine train, which is actually really exciting because I don't know if we've done a spotlight on it yet. This might be the first. Quite surprising, actually. So we have a 6.2 excitement, 5.65 fear, and a 1.71 nausea. There's the rest of the results. We have guests loading up. Let's pause this and pick a seat here. We'll try to do a few different perspectives. No point in doing daytime since it's all underground. So let's just start off with a seat view. Get a feel for those swinging seats. We'll be right back. Wowee. That is quite fast and furious. We'll take a look at the inside of the volcano in a sec. However, I do one bit of feedback would be this misdirect did not quite work as well as it was intended. I get the idea here. We're coming down and we can see the track and it's broken and then we just drop. However, I think that drop is way too drastic. It would just really just break the train. It's so extreme and it feels so weird from the rider perspective. And the problem with that misdirect is we are already dropping and we've got full speed. So even from the rider's perspective in first person, we barely got to see the track before it was like already gone and we're dropping through here. In fact, I kind of want to see the coaster and you can kind of see what I'm saying. That view of the volcano erupting from the rider perspective on the lift was quite brilliant. But yeah, let's take a look at this. It's just so fast. It's crazy. I think that would be the only downside of this creation. I just don't think the misdirect works as well as intended. But the inside of this volcano is quite spectacular. We got gems, we got corpses, we got broken tracks. There is a lot of details in here that I feel like went a little bit unnoticed because I'm seeing all these tracks and things like that. And I didn't really quite get a look at it from the rider's perspective or any of the perspectives that we chose to ride. And I think it's just going a little too fast throughout here, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm just wondering maybe there are, see like this big claw, it's so cool. Maybe if there were ways to face the track towards some of your creations. It's coming, like if the track was coming down this way, we would see some of this stuff come through, pass along the side of this. And we would see all these broken tracks as we're coming around and through. And we come up and we see the claw and that's when we kind of pass by it. So I just feel like the direction, and then we have a face here, look at that. Yeah, the direction that you've chose to face the tracks, it kind of misses some of the details on the inside here. And then that misdirect was a little bit of a hit and a miss for me. But the visual effects and that lift was one of the coolest lifts I've seen in a long time. Coming up here, seeing that big eruption, chaos on the left and the right, lighting was beautiful. And the, you know, having this in your park, it's quite a centerpiece. It's a spectacle, and I would definitely welcome a creation like this into any tropical park. I think it fits very well, and it looks quite amazing. So I still think it will get a lot of downloads, and I think it is a great creation. It looks marvelous. It really is something special. Again, my only feedback would be to somehow rework that misdirect. Maybe just smooth that out and adjust those rocks. But that's just my opinion. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. And yeah, overall a beautiful creation and great for any tropical park. So if you guys want to check it out for yourself, put it in your parks. Links are down in the description below. Come give it a rating. And that's going to do it for this episode of Coaster Spotlight. If you guys enjoyed, please be sure to smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, subscribe for more daily Planet Coaster content. And if you guys would like to support the show to keep it going, you could do so by becoming a patron. All right, everybody, thank you guys so much for watching. And I hope you all have a fantastic day. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye now.